We've been joined by three gentlemen whose band name came from By the Sea.
Yes.
Yes, you did.
What is the name of the band?
Well, I mean, we were up all night sewing these.
Sewing this together.
You can tell this is made with love, okay?
Yeah, Shang-A-Lang, because it's the Bay City Rollers.
It's one for you.
Thank you very much.
And there's one for me. I shall treasure that. Thank you very much indeed.
Very tasteful.
I made that one.
Yeah. So, because the reason that they're here is because you are back together for the first time in decades. Recreating the old magic.
We'll be talking to Bay City Rollers in a couple of moments. Thank you for that. Now, though, a quick last brief look at the headlines wherever you are this morning.
Shang-A-Lang. Shang-A-Lang. Go on, Shang-A-Lang.
Yeah.
Shang your Lang. Welcome back.
Yes, indeed. They were one of the original boy bands back in the 70s. They could draw in crowds of screaming girls wherever they went. The UK really did experience roller mania.
It's nearly 40 years since the Bay City Rollers were at the height of the fame that eventually broke them up. Now, for the first time, three of the original lineup are back on tour. Here with us this morning. Good morning to you, gents.
Lovely to
see
you.
Good morning. Nice to be here.
Before we talk to you, let's hear some of your classics.
Happy Christmas.
Just, we're just
fabulous.
Immersing ourselves in that, in those, the hair, the wardrobe, sort of calf-length baggy trousers,
fantastic. Right? Yep.
And you can never have too much tartan.
Never. Oh, no.
And how long did it take to blow your hair? And
oh, ages. We used to hang upside down in the chair, blow our hair, go like that. Oh God, I'm a pop star.
Oh my goodness. I didn't know until you told me a few moments ago. I expect lots of people will know how you came up with the name, because it's a fabulous name.
Well, what happened was, we had actually like a band called Detroit Wheels, Mitch riding the Detroit Wheels, and then I thought something rolling. And I
got 60 seconds or less. Alan.
Okay, rolls. And then what happened was it wasn't actually a dart, but what happened, I got a map of America,
yeah,
and got a pin, and it stuck in the first one, it stuck in Arkansas, which didn't sound right, Arkansas Rollers. Yeah. And the next one, it stuck in Bay City, and so that's when we went with the Bay City Rollers.
So, but you had to, where did the idea of rollers come from?
Oh, just talking like the rollers, they're actually called the Waves Rollers.
So now, okay, you're back to get again. Of course, we've talked to you before. That's about, you know, your version of the band. But now we've got three originals back together for the first time. What made you get back together?
Yeah, I think it was just a fun thing to do. It seemed about the right time to do that.
Come on,
we've got to sell out Tour.
Some money. Is it the money?
Well, that's certainly a place of Barney. But we've got to sell out Tour in Scotland. We've got a couple of gigs still to do downside. There's one in Manchester the 30th. Is it not 29th?
So you've got a sellout tour. They say you sold out Barrowlands in Glasgow in 3 minutes.
Which prompted all these other
9 minutes.
Four nights sold out in 3 minutes. That's amazing.
That's absolutely fantastic. You were very young when you were first in the band. Was it 16 or how old were you?
I was 17 when I joined. Little Woody's here. He was like 16.
16?
16.
That must have been quite something.
It's great having somebody younger than me slap him over the
back. What, about 6 months or something?
But it was an awful lot of pressure at the time. It was absolutely phenomenal, that roller
because
mania,
we were all quite young, we sort of, you know, got into it okay. It wasn't shocking for us. It just, you know, went completely nuts, but we grew up with that. So.
But it got to you in the end, Alan, didn't it?
Oh, yeah, I left for a couple of years and then I came back again.
And why did you leave the first time?
I just got fed up. I just said,
too old.
You were 25 years old.
What ancient.
To be too old to be in the roller.
But wow. What was it you didn't like?
It was just because it was, like I said, the manager, he was like a kind of control freak, and he was just trying to rule your life, and I just had to get away from him. Mm.
That's the downside, but the upside is he left the band because we never recorded a Christmas album. Which we now have achieved.
That's why he got back together, because you're going to do a Christmas
album. What's it called?
It's called something like Christmas Shang Lang.
What are you going to put on this album then?
It's great. I've been doing it. I'm dreaming of a
tongue in cheek,
fun, but all rollerized. And jingle bells. With a bit of a Sean Connery in there.
Are you still going to wear the calf length trousers?
No, I'm not.
Okay. Shang-a-lang, of course, was a term that came synonymous with you, because you had a TV show, didn't you?
Yeah, called Shang-a-lang. Yeah, it was filmed down here. It's filmed in Manchester.
Was it?
Yeah. Back in the day.
Hey, you are singing Shang-a-lang as well. Let's just have another quick listen, because you can't get enough of it.
My mum made that, swear.
Did she?
No.
She did.
She does?
Yeah. I used to get mine made in the wee shop down the bottom of Coburn Street.
Look, there he is,
Woody,
look. Where's our beat again? There's Alan, look, there's Alan. Yeah.
But were they happy days?
They were.
We're down here last week.
Bands also say, and I think this is your experience too, you know, you did all that stuff and you had hit albums and sold millions of records, but did you actually make anything of it at the time?
Financially, it wasn't very good.
Yeah. That was a bit that was missing from the whole band.
Because you don't think of that when you're in your teens, do you?
But you trust everybody else, don't you?
Yeah. Even now, it's just still a bit rubbish. The people with the money don't want to give it to you, basically.
What about the fans now? What are the audiences
They're
like?
They're great. The fans have stayed with us for all these years. And the last time, as you mentioned, I was on your show, I've been doing my own version of this, trying to sort of keep the thing alive, and it's got more and more popular, and I think that's got a lot to do with us getting back together again as well, because the guys have seen the kind of reaction that we're getting, and now it's like multiplied, you know, it's magnified, it's really great. I think it's amazing because we said, right, we'll get together for one gig at the Barrowlands and just see how it goes. Next minute the promoter's on the phone, can you do another two
Manchester.
I said, listen, just go with it, man, go with the flow.
But I suppose your fans wanted it because they can roll back the years with
the nostalgia,
you for one night, you get to go back to being 16, 15, 14.
That's right. Yeah, absolutely.
But the audiences who turn up, are they still? It was almost exclusively girls at the time.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty mixed now. A lot of the guys that were younger at that point, it wasn't cool to like the band. When that's all turned around now, it's just everybody and anybody.
And are you going to write new material as well as doing a little bit of Christmassy stuff?
Yeah, the Christmas album's the first thing that's going to be out and available to the public very soon on all those popular social media thingy-bajiggy.
Before this Christmas?
That's right, I don't exactly know right now when it's getting released, but I think I was told it's like Friday this week, is it?
It'll certainly be out very soon.
And then before Mother's Day next year, an appropriate time to release
album. Clever!
To release our first album in 40 years. So,
No end to what you can do, because if you could do a Christmas album and then you knew on Mother's Day, you'd have a Valentine's Day album.
Oh, yeah.
Couldn't you?
Hey, we're already there, Bill.
Good. Well, really glad you got back together again.
Thank you very much for having us on the show. Really appreciate it. Helping us out.
There's still a few tickets left for Manchester, and there's still a few left for London Apollo as well.
Okay. Any more plugs? Anything else you want to talk about here?
I would have put that a different way. I would say we've released the last few hundred tickets for the Manchester Apollo.
Happy Christmas.
Indeed. Bay City Rollers are on tour this month. You never guessed.
That's all from us on Breakfast This Morning, Charlie.